감독님 안녕하세요.
Good, thank you very much. It's good to see you all. I'm in San Francisco, so I'm a long way away.
얼마 전에 그 플라스틱 오션을 봤는데요. 진짜 이 플라스틱이 어떻게 바다를 오염시키는지 그 구체적인 과정과 그게 어떻게 생태계에 영향을 미치는지 그거 보고서 너무 충격을 받았거든요. 이거 어떻게 기획을 하시게 된 건가요?
An issue that I actually didn't know anything about until the producer of the film, Joe Ruxton, who is a good friend and a marine biologist, came to me and asked me if I knew about single-use plastics and the effects that they were having on the marine environment. And I had no idea what she was talking about. And I'm an oceans guy. I make documentaries on the oceans. So I was quite shocked that I didn't know anything about this issue. And so what we did was she went off to do some more research in the North Pacific Gyre, one of the big ocean currents where we find a lot of these plastics. And I went out to find out for myself what the problem was. So as I went surfing, I found plastic bags in the water between my feet. I found tiny pieces of plastic on the beach, trapped in seaweed. And when I was diving, I found fishing rope and nets entangled around rocks. And I couldn't work out why I hadn't really seen these things before when, you know, they'd always been there. And I realized that single-use plastic products had become so useful to me and such a part of my life that they'd become invisible.
Look, look.
At 2 o'clock, and another blow four, and it looks like he's got.
This is one of the main areas where we're hunting for the blue whales to film, so this is right in their environment.
They feed by opening their mouth and just sucking up whatever's in their path.
Plastic doesn't degrade. It actually breaks up, and when it's proliferated, there's more opportunities for plastics to be ingested.
A lot of plastic.
Some people, they get cancer, and then some people, they don't pregnant.
If I had not seen this problem, and I'm an oceans guy, then how could anybody who lived in Korea or Mexico or in Central America understand what this problem was if they didn't have an association with the ocean? So as we more research came in and we did more research on the issue and we found out that it was a, you know, a very big, big problem.
저는 그 영화를 보는 내내 진짜 정말 볼 때마다 충격이었거든요, 감독님. 기사로는 많이 접했어요. 우리가 버린 쓰레기로 인해서 뭐 새들이 죽는다. 네. 혹은 뭐 돌고래가 먹고 정말 뱃속에 플라스틱이 가득하다. 기사로는 접했는데 오, 영상으로 보니까
제가 보셨죠? 네. 거기 200몇 개의 네. 플라스틱이 나온 거야. 그러니까 와.
This is a Brutus whale. It's dying, taking its final breaths. It was found to have 6 square meters of plastic sheeting inside it. It couldn't eat and it died of malnourishment. Its digestive system was blocked and it died a terrible, painful death.
다양한 곳에서 찍으셨단 말이에요. 뭐 바다 위도 있고 바다 속으로도 들어가고 뭐 쓰레기 더미 안에서도 막 이제 찍고 그러셨는데 찍으면서 정말 인상적이었던 에피소드가 있으셨을 것 같아요.
Yeah, I think for me personally was the deep shock. The further we went into the filming, and as you mentioned, we went to 21 countries around the world. It took 8 years to film. And that was because as the more we found out about this problem, the bigger it became, the more questions we had. So the film started out as a marine oceans film, but it ended up being a human health film. When I started looking into the very few studies that were around in terms of the effects on human health, I realized that the chemicals in these plastics had the potential to do enormous harm and in some cases were doing enormous harm, but we didn't know very much about it. And I think some of the most shocking facts within the film are related to the human health consequences of this addiction. Specifically through, I think, mainly through children, because what I found with the film was that kids were watching the film. And when we completed the film, I traveled the world and I talked to governments and corporations all around the world about the problem and advised them on solutions. But I also went to schools and I talked to kids everywhere. And I was amazed at how much children actually knew about the problem more than adults. Every time it rains here, every time the wind blows offshore, the sludge, the plastic from all of that rubbish ends up straight.
(웃음) 지금 현재 그 북태평양을 보면은 한반도의 한 14배 정도 크기의 쓰레기 섬이 있대요. 모이고 모여가지고 어느 정도로 크냐 하면은 이제는 유엔에서 2017년도에 하나의 국가로 그냥 지정을 했어요. 이 이슈에 대해서 한 50만 명 정도가 지금 서명을 하고 뭐 이런 큰 움직임이 있는 상태예요.
영화에는 쓰레기 섬이 나왔지만 우리나라에는 쓰레기 산이 있었잖아요. 이게 또 해외에서 CNN에 나오면서 큰 이슈가 됐었고. 여전히 갈 곳을 잃고 떠돌고 있는 쓰레기들이 많다라는 건 이건 좀 생각해 볼 문제인 것 같아요.
100명 정도 조사를 해봤더니 이 혈관 내에 이제 플라스틱이 있더라. 한 86명 정도 그때 나왔다는 거예요. 근데 그때는 우리가 그렇게 많이 쓸 때가 아니었잖아요. 지금은 뭐 100이면 100 다 들어가 있겠지. 그렇죠. 우리는 이미 약간 플라스틱 인간이다라고 볼 수 있는 거죠.
We were talking about human health problems earlier. There was one in 2003. That was done by the Center for Disease Control in America that found that 92.6% of every American they studied had plastic in their blood. And children between the ages of 6 and 11 had twice as much as their parents. And the reason for that was because when a mother gives birth to the baby and breastfeeds the baby, she's transferring all the nutrients from her body to the baby. That's good nutrients and bad nutrients. And of course, what do we do as soon as a baby's born? We wrap it in a plastic nappy. We stick milk in a plastic bottle and feed it with a plastic nipple. We give it plastic toys to play with and to suck from. And so children are growing up with much more plastic in their bodies than us. Now, that study was done in 2003. In the last 10 years, we've produced more plastic than in the entire previous century.
저는 솔직히 너무 두려워요. 아직 우리가 목도하지 않은 거라고 생각하거든요. 이 변화가 지금 진행되고 있고 엄청난 후폭풍을 좀 몰고 오지 않을까 싶어요.
이게 이제 딱 시간이 100년이 지나고 나서는 우리한테 습격을 해올지 상상도 못해요.
재앙이 될 수 있는.
1955년도에 라이프지 표지에 보면은 어떤 사진이 있냐면은 여성들이 이렇게 플라스틱 제품들을 일회용 제품을 이렇게 확 건지는 사진이 있어요. 그러니까 한 번 쓰고 버려라. 이제 이거를 설거지하고 뭐 이러는데
해방이다.
엄청나게 어떤 새로운 세상이 열리는 거는 좋게 얘기했는데 어마어마한 거죠.
전혀 다른 결과를 가져왔네요.
네, 이게 그 기후 변화라든지 환경 문제라는 게 사실은 한 국가만 해결할 수 있는 게 아니잖아요. 이게 전 세계적인 문제이기 때문에 전방위적으로 모두 함께 협력을 해서 해결을 해야 되는데. 어떤 그런 전 지구적인 협력이 좀 잘 이루어지고 있는지.
I don't think there is. I don't think there is enough global work happening. People are trying to solve this independently within each country, and of course each country they do have their own particular problems. But I do think this is something we need to solve globally. And it needs to start with a ban. We've seen the EU do that. We've seen some countries like Australia, my home country now, where individual states got sick of trying to rely on the federal government to show leadership. So they did it themselves. And we've seen states like where I'm from, Tasmania, ban plastic products. And that has snowballed throughout Australia now, where most states now have some sorts of bans. What I was thinking at the time is, how do you change a culture? Kids of and a generation has grown up thinking that this is such an important product and it does provide hygiene. How do you actually do that in somewhere like South Korea? I mean, what if you were given a wish and an ability to solve that problem, how would you do that?
우리의 경험을 보면은 과거에 넘쳐나는 쓰레기를 획기적으로 줄였던 방법은 쓰레기 종량제라는 걸 했을 때잖아요. 그리고 분리수거 거의 의무적으로 하면서 쓰레기 양이 확 줄었는데 그런 식의 뭐 일회용 플라스틱을 아예 법으로 딱 금지하고 생산을 금지하게끔 하는 게 가장 효과적인 것 같고 이제 그렇게 했을 때 그거를 생산하던 회사가 큰 문제가 될 거 아니에요. 다른 어떤 대체적인 뭐 생산을 통해서 그 기업이 망하지 않게끔 할 수 있는 솔루션도 제시해 줄 수 있게끔 뭔가 대안을 만들어 놓고서 일회용 플라스틱 제품 생산이나 수입 자체를 금지하는 법안이 좀 만들어져야 될 것 같아요.
이제 우리가 탄소 배출권이라는 걸 많이 하잖아요. 근데 실제로 탄소 배출권이 거래도 되거든요. 네. 금융상품처럼 거래도 되는데 그게 계속 올라요. 네. 탄소 배출권과 같이 이 플라스틱에 대한 것도 어떤 부담을 좀 그 돈을 버는 쪽에서 하는 게 맞지 않나? 그런 생각도 들고요.
저는 사실은 이런 거를 이렇게 선의에 의지해서는 해결할 수 없다고 봐요. 네, 선의에 의지는 할 수가 없고 어떤 경제적인 인센티브가 굉장히 크든지 아니면 정치적인 어떤 압박에 의해서 해결이 돼야 되는데 말씀하셨다시피 뭐 미국 이야기하셨고 아주 뭐 세계적인 강대국에서 가장 많이 나오거든요. 쓰레기들이. 뭐 주범이라고 할 수 있는 게 중국하고 미국하고 이런 나라들이니까 그러니까 이런 나라들의 중앙정부가 이런 연방 주들이라든지 이런 데를 어떻게 컨트롤 할 수 있겠을 것인가. 그게 이제 가장 관건이라고 생각을 해요.
이제 플라스틱을 안 쓸 수는 없다면은 그냥 자연에서 그 썩어서 없어지는 플라스틱을 일단 기술적으로는 돼 있잖아요. 그걸로 만약에 다 전체 플라스틱 생산을 바꾼다면은 이 문제가 많이 해결될 수 있을까요?
So are you talking about actually swapping from petroleum based plastic polymers to so-called biodegradable plastic polymers. We have to be very careful about so-called biodegradable plastics. Were made from waste products, cornstarch. Unfortunately, with most of them, they require industrial composting to actually break down. Very few cities around the world have industrial composters, and an industrial composter needs to be able to heat the compost to about 120 degrees Celsius. So it's important that you have those facilities, but without those facilities, then these plastics polymers that are made from plant-based products can be actually worse than petroleum-based plastic polymers because people can't tell the difference between them. So when they recycle them with the petroleum-based plastics. And what that does is when it goes to the recycling center, it contaminates the actual petroleum-based plastics that can be recycled. with this plant-based material, and then they have to throw the whole lot out into landfill. And when you get plant-based plastics going into landfill, when it enters and is covered by other material, it sits there, and sometimes it will sit there for 50 to 100 to 200 years because it doesn't get exposed to the oxygen and sunlight that it needs to help with the process of breaking it down. We need to ultimately, I think the solution to the single-use plastic problem is to ban single-use plastics. Just the very name of the product tells you that there's a problem with it. You use it once, it has a single use, and then you throw it away. To me, that's just such a waste of resources. There's very few, if any, single-use plastic products that cannot be replaced by a long-use alternative item. And in fact, many of those items existed before we even started using single-use plastics, and we can go back to them. So my solution to this problem is to simply ban single-use plastics.
재활용이라는 게 저는 사실은 그런 것 같아요. 약간 우리한테 그 죄책감을 벗어날 수
그러니까.
있게 약간
나도
그런 약간 이제
규제나 이런 것들을 더 강하게 해야지만 어떤 그 결과물이 나온다는 거죠.
아까 그러니까 나는 감독님 말씀하신 것처럼 일회용이라는 단어 자체가 없어져야 된다. 그 말이 핵심인 것 같아요. 일회용을 하는 순간 이 문제는 영원히 해결이 안 될 것 같다.
This is a global issue and plastic isn't knows no boundaries, and it's quite possible for plastic to enter the ocean from a river system in North America and be found in Antarctica 40, 50 years later. And in fact, that's what's happened. Scientists have found plastic particles that have come from the other side of the Earth and have been spinning in, around, and off these five major Earth gyres for a long time, causing problems as they do, being eaten by seabirds, passing up the food chain, re-entering, maybe having passed through the food chain or through an animal's system. So a problem created in one country can become another country's problem. And I think that's why, going back to one of your original points, we need to tackle this as a global problem.
그에 앞서서 우리 개개인의 노력도 분명 중요하잖아요. 근데 우리나라 같은 경우에 이제 플라스틱에 관해서 또 환경에 관해서 많은 분들이 더 큰 관심을 갖고 계신데 용기 내 캠페인이라고.
그 용기가 그 용기인가 보죠?
두 가지예요. 그 용기를 가져가, 그릇을 가져가서 내미는 용기, 이런 의미도 있더라고요. 마트나 식당에 가서 본인이 가져간 그릇에 담아주세요 라고 용기를 내는 거죠. 감독님의 다음 프로젝트는 뭘지 좀 기대가 돼요. 이번 플라스틱 오션만큼이나 조이에게 커다란 질문을 좀 던져주실 것 같거든요.
I'd planned to do, but I stumbled across, and that was climate change. I actually went to take time off and to go into the mountains after I made a plastic ocean, and found when I went to the mountains in Europe, there was no snow in the middle of winter. And I started questioning the locals as to why that was the case. And they told me that it had been happening over decades, that every year the snow came later, was less, and that all the glaciers were retreating. And so I started talking to scientists about this to understand what climate change was, and if we as humans were responsible. So we filmed over 4 years. It's called The Last Glaciers, and they reflect sunlight back into the atmosphere to stop the Earth heating. And they are also important water storage devices, providing water downstream for many cities and towns around the world that don't otherwise have access to water. The Himalayas has lost up to 25% of its ice already since 1970s. And by the end of the century, will lose 2/3 of its ice. I was so shocked at how quickly this was happening that I thought that this was another story that needed to be told in a way that we could all understand.
네, 네 앞으로 그 선생님의 다음 작품을 이제 만나게 될 우리에게 꼭 전해주시고 싶은 이야기가 있으면 마지막으로 좀 해주시죠.
We don't need to protect planet Earth. The planet existed before we got here for billions of years. It will exist after we leave. By protecting the planet, we are protecting ourselves. And if we want the next generation to have a future, then it's our generation that has to start that process. We have to make fundamental changes to our economic system, our financial system, where we start to place nature capital as our most important asset.
앞으로도 좋은 활동 기대하겠습니다. 고맙습니다.
Thanks very much for having me. It's been great to talk to you all and to see the awareness that's happening in South Korea.
맞습니다.
감사합니다. 감사합니다.